I'm going to be honest with you. The data analyst job is not all about coding and learning technical skills. A lot of beginner data analysts think that the job requires advanced math, statistics, coding, but that is actually far from the truth. In my data analyst experience, I code about 50% of the time, and the other 50% is spent on meetings, documenting, gathering requirements, and in actuality, as you move up in your data analyst career, you will be coding less. And there are a lot of other misconceptions about the data analyst job that I want to dispel in this video so that you know exactly what to focus on as you become a data analyst. Line number one, it's all about math and coding. One of the biggest misconceptions about the data analyst job is that it requires advanced math and statistics. While these skills are super useful to have, these aren't the most important skills that a data analyst should have. And this is because a large part of a data analyst's job is to ask the right questions to really understand the problem they're solving for. Let me give you an example. As a data analyst, I frequently get a lot of questions from stakeholders where they will tell me what they're looking for without actually telling me what they're looking for. So they'll say, "Can you give me the total sales number?" And when I give them the total sales number, they then will come back and say, "Oh, can you break that number down by customer and sales date?" And when I do that, they then come back again. And it's this back and forth until I finally stop and ask, "What is it that you are looking for? What is it that you're trying to solve for?" And when I ask those questions, that's when I really am starting to figure out what it is that they're actually looking for, because a lot of time you will find that the stakeholder does not truly know what they are looking for, and they'll just ask you to solve the problem a certain way when that may actually not be the best way to do the analysis. So if you're just starting to learn data analysis, I would highly recommend Coursera, who is today's sponsor. If you've been living under a rock and haven't heard, Coursera offers a Google Data Analytics Professional Certificate, which is extremely flexible and for beginners. It teaches not only the technical skills, but also the key data analytical skills that a data analyst should know. My favorite part of the course is that it teaches the fundamentals of data, as well as a dedicated section on how to ask the right questions for data-driven decisions. This is definitely something I struggled with when I first became a data analyst. I would take the problem as is and spend hours building a dashboard or an analysis, come to find out that I did it completely wrong and have to redo it, all because I didn't ask the right questions. That's why it's so important that there is a whole section dedicated to learning how to ask effective questions and managing your stakeholders with actionable tips that anyone can really implement. And if you're interested in the course, check out the link in the description below. And thank you so much, Coursera, for sponsoring this video. Line number two, data analysts work alone. A lot of people think that data analysts don't have to talk to anybody. They think of it as a job where you're sitting behind a computer all day and you can be this cozy little hermit in the corner and not have to interact with people. But in truth, the job actually requires talking to people because you're ultimately doing data analysis for people. I have to say, when I first started my data analyst career, I was surprised by the number of meetings and interactions I had with people. There are some days where I won't talk to anybody, but there are other days where it's just back-to-back meetings. I barely catch a lunch break, and my meetings are with stakeholders, other engineers, and team meetings that really fill up your whole day. So remember, the data analyst job does require quite a bit of communication, and that is a skill you should definitely have as a data analyst. Line number three, the data analyst job is glamorous. When you look up the word data analyst on TikTok, you'll see all the posts saying how it's an easy remote job. You can work from anywhere in the world and you're making six figures doing effortless work. Social media definitely idealizes the data analyst life. And even at work, it's actually pretty common that your stakeholders too will believe that data analysis is a simple task, when in reality, it can be extremely challenging and take a lot of time. The assumption that data analysis is simple does lead to tight deadlines and pressure. It's actually pretty common that I'll have stakeholders pinging me last minute, asking for ad hoc work, especially with a timeline of ASAP as soon as possible. And as unexpected problems arise in the business that require data-driven analysis, that's when data analysts will pick up the work and they have a lot of requests that come in that need immediate attention. So in reality, analyzing data properly and extracting meaningful insights does take a lot of time and effort, and it is not always as glamorous as social media makes it out to be. Line number four, it's not a customer-focused job. A common misconception is that the data analyst job doesn't require any customer service. And yes, it's not the same service that a restaurant server will provide, but there is a level of service required because your customers are your stakeholders and the product that you're providing is your dashboard or your analysis or your data solution that you're giving them. At work, we actually refer to our stakeholders as customers, and we do a lot of our work based on the customer's needs and have a customer-focused mindset as we do our work. These things include creating a self-service data analysis so customers can do their own analysis rather than asking every time they need something, listening to the customer and providing solutions by translating their problems into solutions, and iterating on dashboards that we build based off the customer feedback. While the primary role of a data analyst isn't to provide direct customer service, the job really does entail working with customers and building data solutions for them. Line number five, all data analysts do the same work. You may think that all data analysts use the same tools, skills, do the same analysis everywhere they work, which is a false statement. The daily tasks that a data analyst is assigned will really depend on the skills that they have as well as the needs of the organization. Common tasks do include cleaning, analyzing, visualizing data, but this can mean a number of things. It could be Power BI or it could be building a model. It is helpful to learn the typical tech stack of a data analyst, but keep in mind that not all analysts use the same tools because it will really vary depending on the organization. For example, an organization may have Tableau, but the data analyst may actually work more with SQL and Excel as their primary tool. So fundamentally, the data analyst does similar tasks, but keep in mind that it can widely vary based on the organization. I'd like to know if any of these lines are surprising to you, as a lot of these were new to me when I first became a data analyst, and I really hope that it helps you learn the right skills to become a data analyst. Please like and subscribe to the channel and watch my next video where I give you more actionable tips on how to become a data analyst. Thank you so much and I will see you there.